Chapter 770, Conversing with the Dragon. You want to meet that evil dragon? Why? He was slightly astounded. Maybe I can reach an agreement with those evil dragons. They seem to dislike the three Gu races greatly. Keenly expressed. He thought for a moment and then said, the evil dragons and the three Gu races are indeed great enemies. Everyone was surprised. Before the heaven-fighting race descended upon Spirit Realm, the evil dragons fought frequently with the three Gu races. When the heaven-fighting race came to this world, and the major races surrendered, the evil dragon race became a weapon of the heaven-fighting race. Supposedly, one of the conditions for the evil dragon surrender was to destroy the three ghoul races. When the heaven-fighting race tried to exterminate the three ghoul races, the evil dragon race was one of the major participants. It is logical that these two races will immediately fight when they meet each other. As one of the best artificers of Celestial Artifact Sect, he had some knowledge about the ancient era. My knowledge of the three ghoul races comes from an ancient book. While I know of the three ghoul races, and know their history with the evil dragons, I do not recognize them. He explained. So without you pointing them out, even if I met one of them, I wouldn't be able to tell from which race they belong to. Kinlai nodded. Are you confident that you will not be killed after meeting the evil dragon? The evil dragon race is bloodthirsty, murderous, savage, cruel, emotionless, cunning and devious. They do not seem to have any good traits. Are you sure? He asked again. I think I will be fine. Kinlai put his hand on the demon sealing tombstone and said, I have this. All right, then go down. We can wait for you a bit. He nodded slightly. This, isn't it be too dangerous? Why do you have to see the evil dragon? Many people expressed their puzzlement. Kinlai did not explain anything. He jumped off Shan Yu's golden-winged Luan and directly fell into a hole in the Absolute Yin graveyard. He moved towards the dark and cold underground. The six spirits of void and chaos had previously chased the members of the three ghoul races deep into the ground and scattered around the stone palaces. The spirits became his ears and eyes. Recalling six spirits' paths, he continued his descent. What he saw along the way were bloody corpses of the three ghoul races. Most of the corpses had been torn to pieces, and many had been dissolved by corrosive liquid into bloody skeletons. The scenes he saw along the way were extremely bloody. The thick tang of blood was nauseating. An entire hour later, traveling through the hidden passageways under the ground, he was nearly 10 kilometers under the surface when he finally came to the stone palace where the evil dragon Gilbert was. Whoosh whoosh whoosh, whoosh whoosh whoosh. The spirits of void and chaos which had been scattered around other places came and spun around him, looking like miniature suns. Kinlai looked and found that the bodies of the spirits had turned into balls that seemed to be swelling like balloons. Whoosh. Before he could say a word, the six spirits of void and chaos returned into the soul-suppressing orb to rest as though they were deathly tired. He realized that the next time the spirits of void and chaos come out again, they will have truly leveled up. All of a sudden, a dragon claw suddenly descended. Before he could react, the dragon claw gripped his body. After turning and spinning, he finally steadied his body. Then he found the dragon claw moved him in front of Gilbert's eyes. The evil dragon Gilbert's eyes were like large green lanterns which seemed dark and eerie in the dim stone palace. Yet if one looked loosely into the eyes of this enormous evil dragon, they would find two imprints that were unique to the Blaze family. When Kinlai saw the two imprints, his worries suddenly disappeared. He grinned, relaxed. He started to channel his bloodline power. Wisps of fierce flame came out of his blood, countless divine characters flowing and flew out of his body, making him appear dazzling. Gilbert's claw that held him was burned by the blazing flames. The dragon couldn't help but grunt. When Kinlai used a secret art to activate his bloodline and have it burn even brighter, blazing flames even appeared in Gilbert's eyes. Gilbert suddenly started to cry in pain. At that time, Kinlai finally put away his bloodline power, stopped and asked, does the oath of the evil dragon race still hold? Previously, when he had been burning his blood above the Absolute Yin graveyard, he had seen some things from the bloodline. He was right. The evil dragon race had once sworn allegiance to the heaven-fighting race. After this oath had formed, the descendants of the heaven-fighting race could go to the evil dragon race to pick an evil dragon as a steed after maturing. Once the heaven-fighting race descendant and the chosen evil dragon formed a bond, an elder of the heaven-fighting race would leave an imprint unique to the family on the evil dragon. As it turned out, this dragon called Gilbert had the imprint of the Blaze family. That imprint had been left by the demon sealing tombstone before Gilbert woke up. Kinlai learned these secrets from deep within his bloodline. On top of that, he also learned a secret art to activate the imprint in the evil dragon using his bloodline. This secret art was why he dared to come alone under the Absolute Yin graveyard to meet this evil dragon. This was because he had seen through the spirits of void and chaos the imprint unique to the Blaze family in the eyes of the evil dragon. My race will never break our oaths. Gilbert said in the spirit realm's common language. Descendants of a god race can come to my race to pick their partner. They can pick those that are below rank 8 and have not been named. And I, the noble and magnificent Gilbert, am an evil dragon that had reached rank 8 and possess a true name. An evil dragon with a true name cannot become your steed. Also, you aren't a pure blood, and you are so weak. Therefore, you do not qualify to become my master. Gilbert howled. I have not come to enslave you. I do not need you to become my steed. I came to discuss a partnership with you. Kinlai said with a slight smile. Partnership? Gilbert became puzzled and then he snorted, saying disappointedly, as expected, you are not a pure blood after all. The true members of a god race would never discuss a partnership. Oh, then what would they do? Kinlai asked helplessly. Submit or kill. They never give people another choice. Gilbert said relevantly, other than you, are there any other evil dragons here that possess a true name? You are only rank 8. If you encounter the old ghouls with 2 or 3 level soul lauders, do you believe you will survive? No. Kinlai nodded and laughed. Well then, you are in big trouble. Right now, there are at least 13 soul alter ghoul experts fighting with human soul alter experts in the sky above. The reason they have not reached this place yet is because they haven't had the time, Gilbert suddenly bellowed. If we did not follow your god race into the War of the Hundred Races, so many of my race would not have died. If the members of my race who possess true names were here now, then those old ghouls would have all become our food by now. But you are the only one here. Kinlaruli interrupted him. Speak. What do you want? Gilbert howled angrily. Hiding down here is not a good solution. Once the battle in the skies is determined, as long as soul alter experts from the three ghoul races are still alive, they will come here and exterminate the evil dragon race, using your flesh and blood to quickly recover their strength. Kinlai said coldly, what else are we supposed to do? Gilbert howled angrily, flapping his wings. He spun in the stone palace and said, full of hatred, after you of the god race were defeated, you left the spirit realm for the outer space. You only took a small number of my race with you. Most of the evil dragons, those without true names below rank 8, had been abandoned. We had to face the pursuit of the humans, Azure, Wood, Dragon and other ancient beast races. Do you know how we survived? Kinlai was silent. Many of my race were captured alive. They were skinned and had their bones extracted to become spirit materials, to become their food. The auxiliary wards that you bestowed upon us fell one by one, and were divided up by those victorious races. The space we could live in grew smaller and smaller. As long as we were alive, as long as our dragon souls were in dragon bodies, our dragon aura would not disappear. They could find us through our dragon aura. In order to survive, me and my clansmen shattered our souls, and shattered the dragon soul through secret arts. We left our dragon souls scattered about and separated from the dragon body. We hid deep in the ground and lived in a fake death state. Because of this, we gave up any hopes of ever breaking through in our cultivation. And all of that was because you once promised that you would come back one day. So we hid deep in the ground, and waited in this quasi-death state. We were waiting for your return. When he said this, the evil dragon Gilbert paused and looked deeply at Kinlai. He said, unfortunately, you are not the person we are waiting for. Kinlai maintained his silence. He knew that the evil dragons were waiting for a true member of the god race. They were waiting for the members of the god race to come again from outer space and start a new era for spirit realm. I am not the person you are waiting for. A moment later, Kinlai said with a grave expression, but your situation right now is not good. You must do something, otherwise, you will be killed by the ghouls, or by the human experts that will come in the future. The reality in front of this branch of evil dragons was that cruel,